Hello friends, nice to meet you again. You are welcome in my channel, The Literary Mind. In today's video, I am going to tell you about the summary of this book. It's actually a play, The Pot of Gold, and it's written by Pettus. For your kind information, I want to tell you that in earlier two videos, I have given you this it's my third video. In the first video, I have told you about this course of English Honors. Okay, all information I have given to you about the generic subject which you will have to fill in the form which you will have to opt in the first year, first semester. And after that, in the second video, I have given you the summary of Kalidas. Okay, so you can search that. Okay, I have given the link in the description. You can follow there. You can watch this video, that video. Okay, so in today's video, this is the book. Okay, The Pot of Gold. So don't be misguided by the thickness of the book, that how we will finish. So it's actually, there are three or four plays I think inside it. So only first play that is coming in our syllabus in Delhi University's first year, first semester exam. Only first play will come, that is actually The Pot of Gold. So before starting, I want to tell you, I want to show you the, you can see here, the characters. Okay, so the characters, Lar Familiarsis, a household word as prologue. Okay, the main characters are Euclio, Staphyla. Euclio, a miserly old man, बड़ा ही कंजूस टाइप का एक इंसान होता है, ठीक है, स्टाफाइल है, हिज हाउसकीपर यू कैन से टाइप ऑफ मेड. ओके, मेगाडोरस हिज नेबर यूनोमिया, सिस्टर ऑफ मेगाडोरस. ओके, लाइकोनिडीज, अ यंग मैन एंड सन ऑफ यूनोमिया, एंड आफ्टर दैट स्ट्रोबिलस, स्टीवर्ड टू मेगाडोरस, अ टाइप ऑफ सर्वेंट स्टीवर्ड. स्ट्रोबिलस इज अ मैन नेम्ड स्ट्रोबिलस. ओके, he is a steward to Megadorus. Megadorus servant, you can say. After that, a Congrio, a cook, खाना बनाने वाला, ठीक है. After that, Anthrax, another cook, ठीक है, दूसरा खाने बनाने वाला. After that, a slave of Lyconides, and Phaedria, daughter of Euclio. So these are the characters. But basically, the story will run in between these two or three characters, I can say, that is Euclio, Megadorus, Eunomia, Lyconides. Okay, these are the basic characters. So yes, starting the summary. Lar Familiarsis is a family god. For example, in Indian family we have a family god now, like Shiva, Lord Shiva, Lord Ram. So same they are having, that is Euclio is having a family god, that is Lar Familiarsis. Okay, and after that he is having a two miser person, and is having a girl child. Okay, he's having a daughter, and his daughter is of the age, suppose she has to be married. She has been young already. So in the marriage of Phaedria, daughter of Euclio, the Euclio don't even want to spend a single penny of rupees in the expenditure of Phaedria's wedding. Okay, he's such a miser person. So Lar Familiarsis, the family god, and already I have told you about the prologue, that before the starting of a play, always a prologue is given. So same is here, a prologue is given in this play also. So why is it's a play? Because one person finishes his dialogue and after that another person comes. So it's a play. It's a play. Okay. So whenever you will read this novel line to line, you will really, it's a type of you will get a humor sense. Okay. In the later part of the story, in the climax part of the story, climax is actually, what is climax? Climax is the end of the story. Okay, so at the climax point, you will find that this story is creating a laugh, creating a reason for laugh. Okay, so starting the story. So Lar Familiarsis think that Euclio is such a miser person, how he will be marrying his daughter. So he gives her treasure. He gives a treasure to Euclio, and Euclio, after finding the treasure, after searching for the treasure, he thinks that he has become rich, and now he will not tell anyone about this treasure, and due to this treasure, he has lost everything, like night's sleep, okay, and he has become a forget type of person. Every time he just forgets, बेचैन हो जाता है हर वक्त, ठीक है, कि मेरे पैसे को कोई ना ले ले, so that no one can steal his money, steal his treasure. So even the stewards, the persons who has been working in his home, he suspects them that these person can steal their steal his money. That's why Staphyla is actually a steward to Euclio, okay, Staphyla. So Euclio suspects on Staphyla that Staphyla can steal the treasure. Every time she just make him away from the house, saying that you can, he don't tell Staphyla that what is the reason that he is expelling him out from the house, but just he expel him out and abuses him without a reason. Staphyla don't know what is the reason behind that. That's why the owner is behaving in such a manner. Okay, she don't know. So every time, due to this treasure, Euclio has got a, what we can say, just forget. Okay, बेचैन हो जाता है वो बंदा पैसे के कारण. After that, in the family, anyone don't know that actually Euclio has got a treasure. Anyone don't know. Even his daughter don't know that his father has got a treasure. And after that, in the story, later part of the story, you can see that there is a person named Megadorus. So Megadorus' sister, that is what Eunomia. Yes, Eunomia is the sister. Eunomia comes to Megadorus, and Megadorus is the neighbor of Euclio, the miser person who has got a treasure. So Megadorus says that Megadorus' sister says that Megadorus, you have been a middle-aged person, so now you should marry. So Megadorus says that who will marry me? Now I have been old. So who will marry me? So his sister says that yes, you can be married. So if any girl, if you like any girl, so tell me. So Megadorus says that yes, I like a girl, and that girl is the same, the person having, that is the Euclio's daughter. I love him. Okay. So Megadorus says, and Megadorus' sister says that yes, you if you love him, love her, then you should express your love to his father. So Megadorus goes there, went there, and asked for the motion, saying that Euclio, I want to talk to you. So Megadorus is very rich person, and Euclio is very miser person and very poor person. So Euclio, what Euclio thinks, what Euclio's mentality is that yes, Megadorus has come to him, a rich person is coming to a poor person, there would have definitely been a reason behind this. Maybe he's coming to show off his richness and to make me feel hurt, okay, to make me feel poor, okay. So he feels like that. But Megadorus' real purpose was to ask for the hand of his daughter, okay. So Megadorus says that I want to marry your daughter, I like her. So Euclio said that how it could be possible. Maybe that's an interesting part of the story. What Euclio thinks, you will really be entertained after hearing this, that what Euclio thinks, that why Megadorus has came. He thinks that Megadorus has get to know about the treasure. That's why he's asking for the hand of his daughter, so that by the dowry, he can get all the treasure. He thinks so. So you can think about the mentality of such a type person, Euclid. And after that, Megadorus says that, Euclid says that how I can pay for all the spendings that will be required in the wedding. So Megadorus says that no, you need not to worry about that. I will spend all these spendings. It will be my responsibility to manage all these things. So he manages cooks for Euclid too, so that the wedding arrangements can be done. Also musicians, flute persons, all everyone is just paid by the Megadorus. Everything just goes fine, and after that what happens, everything goes fine. And on the other hand, Megadorus, Euclid is in, when the cook enters his house, he don't know about that the person, that is Congrio, is a cook hired by Megadorus. So Euclid don't know that it's a cook. He thinks that that person is actually a thief and he has entered his house to steal the treasure. He thinks so. And he suddenly attacks on his head, and just blood spills out from his head, from Congrio's head. Just the blood comes out from his head. And Congrio said that, yes, this person has actually got mad. Okay. This person, without having any reason, just attacked on me. And more than what I will be paid, I will have to spend much more on the treatment that will be done with my head. Okay, so Congrio, and after that after expelling Congrio from the house, Euclid checks that if the treasure is present in the house or not. So you can think that what a type of person Euclid is. Basically very very miser person. Okay. And after that, Euclid finds that yes, the treasure is safe. So he calls back Congrio, and after that, Congrio tells that I am a cook hired by Megadorus, and I am here to prepare for your wedding processions. Okay. And after that, he asks for the wood. Where is the fuel to cook food? So he says that ask to Megadorus that where is the fuel. I am not going to spend any money. So Megadorus came and he pays for the fuel. Okay. So it's just I have given you this summary till now. And after that, what happens? Megadorus' son. And after that, during this time, the Euclid thinks that yes, it's the treasure is not safe in the house. So he thinks that he should make it safe somehow. So he goes to a place, and after that hide it there. Okay, I have forgotten the name of that place. But he hides that there. Okay, and on the other part of the story, what is happening? Somehow, Lycaonides, the son of Eunomia, that is actually Megadorus' sister's son, okay, Lycaonides, who is the ex-lover of Phaedria, that is actually the son of Euclid, okay. So Lycaonides Eunomia is actually the mother. So Lycaonides used to love Phaedria, the son of the daughter of Euclid, and Phaedria has been pregnanted by Lycaonides. So this was the thing that was hidden with both the families. Both the family didn't know about this thing, that Phaedria is actually been pregnanted by Lycaonides. So Lycaonides, after hearing this news that actually his maternal uncle is going to marry Phaedria, He thinks that how I can stop this, because I am going to marry him, marry her. So how I can stop? He tells his this thing to his maternal uncle, and his maternal uncle says that yes, I am ill-fated. So you should try. I will not marry this girl now. Now it's the property of yours. So you should marry now. So in the earlier part of the story, I have already told you now that Euclio has gone to hide the treasure. So from here, Lycomedes sent a slave to Euclio to tell Euclio that you can say that by mistake or really he has pregnanted his daughter, and now he is going to marry his daughter. So he says he sent the slave saying so. The slave goes, and suddenly in the way he finds that Euclio is hiding the treasure. He watches Euclio hiding the treasure, and Euclio suddenly watches the slave, and he says that, "You fool person, why are you here? Why are you looking me?" So he just expel him out from that area where he was hiding the treasure. And after that, Euclio thinks that this place is not safe. He should go anywhere else to hide this. So he goes another place, and after that, the slave also pursue him in a secret manner. And after that, Euclio just hides the treasure there, and after that, the slave watches that where the treasure has been hidden by Euclio. Euclio comes back to his home, but actually there is a fear that his treasure could be stolen by anyone. He is having such fear in his mind every time. So whenever he was coming from there, कुछ गलत उसके साथ घटने लगता है. क्रो जस्ट कौवा उसके ऊपर बीट कर देता है, ठीक है, मतलब दिस टाइप्स ऑफ थिंग्स. ओके, सो एक्चुअली इन इंडियन सोसाइटी दीज थिंग्स, ये चीज़ें जो हैं ये गलत मानी जाती है, मतलब ठीक है, आप सगुन सगुन कह सकते हो, आप कहते नहीं है, ठीक है. सो आफ्टर when he goes there again to check the treasure, if the treasure is present there or not, so he finds that yes, the treasure has been theft by anyone, and he just whipped there. Okay, he comes to his home, and after that, on the other part of the story, the slave goes to the Lycomedes and says to Lycomedes that yes, I have met Euclio, and this is the treasure the Euclio was hiding. Please take it and free me from slavery. So it can be a theme of this story, that to be free from slavery, what a person can do. So you should focus in that part of the story to buy the slavery, to be free from the slavery. He just gives all the money to Lycomedes and asks for the freedom from the slavery. He want to enjoy slavery. The slave wanted to enjoy slavery, but Lycomedes says that you are free. But take this money and give it to Euclio back. So Lycomedes himself goes to the house of Euclio, and there Euclio was weeping at the doorstep. So Lycomedes says, after going there, Lycomedes actually was thinking that what he will tell, that he has pregnanted his daughter. So he was confessing about it, that how he could explain that, and any wrong step Euclio could take, he could beat, he could anything like that. So he was thinking about that. So here is a interesting part of the story. Here you will get aapko hansi aayegi yahan pe. Here you will actually laugh. It's a comedy here, that Euclio says that who has थेफ्ट माई मीन्स दीज टाइप्स ऑफ लाइन, मतलब मुझे किसने बर्बाद किया है, तो लाइक ऑलरेडी सोचता है कि इट वॉज मी हु हैज करप्टेड हिज डॉटर. ओके सो लाइक ऑलरेडी ऑन हिज बिहाफ थिंग्स दैट ही हैज करप्टेड यूक्लियो बाई प्रेगनेंटिंग हिज डॉटर, बट यूक्लियो सेज दैट हु हैज करप्टेड मी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ बाय स्टीलिंग द प्रेजेंट, बट लाइक ऑलरेडी थिंग्स दैट he has robbed his daughter, that's why he was saying so. So he says that I am the person who has corrupted your, I am the person who has corrupted you. So means these types of questions and answers in a misguided way the conversation goes on, and finally Lycaonides, finally Euclid says that Lycaonides, I have not thought that you have been gone so much deep, you have means tumhari value itni gir gayi hai, you have degraded your value in such a way, I have not thought about that. So Lycaonides said, what type of value you are talking about? Actually I am actually the faulty person, I have pregnanted your son, and really I'm feeling same, but I want to marry him. So every doubt just clear from that conversation, and after that they are married. So it's just end of the story, but in the end of the story, that is the climax part, which I was telling that you will get some comedy portion here so you will, when you will read the story line to line, you will get about that. It's a very interesting story, and you will feel comedy there. Okay, so friends, it's enough for today. It was story of and a summary of Fort of Gold. I hope that you would have liked my video. So you can refer from the above links the previous two videos. It was my third video. So you can refer from there. I have already given it the links in the description box. Please follow me, like, share, give me more and more likes, more and more shares, so that I can be so much enthusiastic to upload more videos, because whenever I will not get more likes, more views, so I will quit this job, because I'm not guaranteeing any profit from here. Just I'm fond of teaching, that's why I am giving it to you people. Okay, I'm just doing some type of job that is for the welfare of the people, because I have got all these things from someone, so why should I not donate it? I believe in donating something. So okay friends, bye for today, and I hope that you would have liked my video. Please subscribe, share, and like much more. Okay, bye friends.